Adesso io vorrei dare veramente un grande, sentito, calorosissimo benvenuto a Lacaton. Grazie per essere qua. I shift to English to introduce you. I don't think that Lacaton really needs any particular presentation with Jean-Philippe Vassal, her partner, Lacaton&Vassal architect. They won the Pritzker Prize 2021, Miss Van der Rohe Award 2019, and the Golden Medal of l'architecture.
Nothing in Italy.
Not in Italy.
No prize in Italy.
No
Not
prize
yet.
In Italy. This is an interesting thing. But a quantity of the most prestigious international award. And she also has studied in the most prestigious university all around the world, Harvard, ATH, and in Lausanne, PFL, in Madrid, also in Alghero. That is an interesting thing. This is in Italy, yes. So I don't think that you really need any particular presentation from that point of view. But I would like just to say a few words remarking why we decided to invite, and we are so happy and honored and also proud somehow to open this edition of Arch Week with your lecture. I think that the work that you did since the beginning of your career has always worked in a very deep, radical, researching way. And also optimistic, we were saying a few minutes before. This is something that is so interesting to understand, that now the most prestigious award all around the world are saying, yes, this is a successful way of doing architecture. Because you never, I think, worked within the logic of success, but within the logic of research and of listening of the context and neighborhood and reality of things, working with what exists, with the things that already exist in the world, in the city, in the peripheries, in the territories that are not so special, but that they are special because they contain our life. And so this, I think, is a sort of manifesto, if we can say, of what we would like to work on for this edition of Arch Week, and maybe also for the next years in Triennale in Milano, hopefully. It is this particular way of thinking on what is architecture, what we can do as architects. In 2007, a very interesting and strange book came out, Plus. It was with Frédéric Drouot, which I would like to mention, which was this strange idea of transforming buildings without demolishing, also without putting away people of it, but just improving these obsolescent and old and failure buildings. And that seems like, when the book came out, was super interesting to me, but it seems like an utopia. And then, along the decades, that became true with many, many projects and many real interventions that are there and that improve lives of a very big amount of people. I don't know exactly, maybe this can be an interesting question. And this is something that really, I think, deserves to be underlined to understand what can be our profession. I think that your work changed the perception of what an architect can do as a professional in the world for people, for our citizens, for people. So thank you so much. Please, the floor is yours.
So thank you very much for the invitation. I'm very pleased to be again here in this school that I like very much this building, which I must say inspired us a lot when we had to design a new school of architecture in France 15 years ago. And I like this school because it's more than a building. It's a space of life which is open to changes, to education, but also to exhibitions, to welcome public, but also in a very very simple and very close connection with outside. For me, this building, in a way, represents absolutely the opposite of all what's the norms about thermics, about how we should consider the buildings today as closed box, totally separated, insulated of outside. So I like very much this place, and please keep it like it is. today, the topic of the lecture will be about transformation. Transformation, make do with the existing and with available resources. It's a subject, as you mentioned in the introduction, which is for us very important since many years. When we are studying in the School of Architecture in Bordeaux, it happened the demolition of a very nice housing building, a tall building, kind of long curve bar, with very good housing along the river, with a very nice situation. And just because there were some social problems in the neighborhood, and finally the building became the kind of responsible of these problems, and it was demolished. And from that time, as young architects, we were a bit shocked by this demolition, because it was 20 years ago. For us, as architects, we would take a lot of interest lessons from the modernism. It was a kind of unacceptable attack against the modernity, against what it has brought to the architecture, and against this period of the 70s, 60s, when the housing has become a public vision, something very important in the life, and with all the mistakes we know about this period, with all the things that should have never been done. But we can take from this time very interesting lessons. So from that time, and a little time later, followed by this national program of demolition of modern housing, we decided to study very carefully this issue of demolition. And we arrived to this book that you mentioned. So the transformation of the existing is a very important issue and a big part of the solution to make the city better. And even more, it's also bringing solutions facing the global climate changes that we are facing, and that we have to find solutions which are not only just to put insulation around all the existing buildings that in a way totally degrade the quality of the housing inside, but we have to find much better solution than that. So the transformation is part of this solution. Transformation is about using what we already have and make the better use of it. It's about considering the existing as a resource and a preliminary value, instead of seeing the existing only as a problem. Most of what exists still has a lifespan that can be prolonged, updated, upgraded with accuracy, precision, to last still a long time. Transformation means taking with you the values of the existing and its strengths in order to make them the driving force of a new project. The existing offers already a lot of build. Using it allows to reduce drastically the need of new materials to build, the need of always using new territories around the cities to build. Transformation is an economy of gesture, of material, of CO2, a social economy, an economy, in short, favorable to the essential. Today, the existing situation, we can say that the existing situation are the new material for the projects. Making with nature, with trees, with soils, with flowers, with animals, with everything already there, that was the challenge of this project of house that we built almost 20 years ago. And the question here in this wonderful landscape with a big forest along along this bay, the question is how to slip into the nature without damaging. Generally, when the houses have been built around, they started to make a clearing, cutting trees around to build the house in the middle. In this case, we observed the place, and the place was a plot, was made with, was full of 45 pine trees, which were, for some of them, at the end of their life, but they were still there. And what we decided to make the house without cutting any tree. So the house, the plot was a sand dune, so we proposed to have a very light construction with little small steel elements that could be brought on the place without big tracks, to have very thin piles of foundation without any connection in the foundations, in order to keep the sand dune as it was, as it is, to elevate the house of 4 meters in order to keep the ground natural, and to build the house with the trees crossing the house. So the construction is very simple. It's not a scenography. The construction has not been changed because of the trees. It's a kind of regular grid that means the nature to try to slip into the nature very gently. So the house at the end is this one, with some trees inside that cross in some places. Of course, we try not to have partitions and place of trees. And inside, the landscapes is dominating. It's not the architecture. The architecture, in a way, disappears to let the place, but it creates all the same a space where it's possible to stay and to have this good connection with the site. So inside, the trees are crossing. Since 20 years, one tree has been cut because they were very old, 80 years old. But it's not a problem because the house was not made to scenography, to stage the trees, but just to let them live until their end of the life. Making with the existing is also the opportunity to profit of the qualities already there for a more sustainable master planning. This was a situation in the periphery of a small city in the west of France, Saint-Nazaire, along the Atlantic Ocean. And the plot is there in the periphery of the city, which is there. This place was a former city, a former natural forest. In some places like this, they have a very precious values for their quality and their character. At the same time, it's also necessary to compose with the need of building in the city for housing, for equipments, without losing any value. So the challenge is there. How to keep the values already there, but also keeping on building, because we need also to build in city instead of expanding always the city more and more outside. So here the challenge was how to keep this forest, which was a natural forest. And in fact, the forest was like this, very very strong. But when we were observing the maps from the past, the forest was reducing more and more because more and more construction were reducing its perimeter. And the competition brief was to build on this space with this beautiful forest, with a kind of biotope of birds, of little animals, insects, of flowers. The challenge here, also this former building, totally abandoned because it was the place of the university and this was the administration of the university. So in the brief, this building should be demolished. And the brief, in fact, was to build here an eco-quartier, an ecological neighborhood of 250 houses in the middle of the city occupied by this forest. The first simulations of implementing these 250 houses very fast showed that this typology of neighborhood, one house on one plot, would completely replace the forest by the construction. So this approach of building houses on this place for us was completely contradictory with a brief which was to build an eco-quartier. How can you be ecological in one hand, but starting a new project by tabula rasa and making the plot empty to build on it? So we didn't want to follow this approach to design the project. And for us, the right question was how to keep a forest in the city and make this compatible with the construction of new housing. So we decided not to follow the brief and to abandon the principle of building 250 houses, but to build the equivalent of apartments on collective blocks. These blocks were detached from the ground of 12 meters. So the first level of the housing was at 12 meters above ground. So it allowed to keep the natural ground and to keep the forest below the construction. So the ground floor was almost the natural ground with just a very few stairs and some elevators that would allow to join the housing. And the former building was kept, and we put the car parking on the place which is already sealed by car parking. So the level at 12 meters, that was the first level of construction here, very dense, but with good quality of housing, with generous housing, all of them, with double orientation, with balconies and terrace on the both sides. And this process was also the opportunity to regenerate the forest, which was on the way of disappearing. So the state of the forest when we did the project was this one, year first. After 1 year, after 4 years, we could expect already regeneration. And again, after 40 years, the forest could have recovered his full occupation and his full strength. So this is the renderings, because we have not been farther than the competition. So the renderings of these housing blocks with the ground, which remains natural and remains as a public space, open to public and not privatized. Some stairs that would lead to a common circulation that would allow to reach the apartments in order not to have too many construction on ground. This circulation a little below the first level, and the apartments at the level of the canopy with a very nice view on the forest and on the sea. So surprisingly, we didn't win the competition, even if some people of the owner and the municipality were interested, but in a way they didn't take the decision to make it. So today, the forest is not existing anymore because they did not 250 houses, but almost, and the forest has totally disappeared. So beyond this project, it's very interesting to ask the question of the real sense of this this project of eco neighborhood. What does it mean in reality? In fact, it's eco at the end, at the very end, because it doesn't count the situation before. But if you count the situation before and what has been destroyed, demolished to make these new neighborhoods, it takes 50 years to recover the value that of this new construction. So in any case, taking what is already there is a preliminary value that is absolutely big and huge. So make with the value of the place. It's about the project of a small square in the city of Bordeaux. In 1996, there was a new mayor in the city who decided to make a large project of embellishment of the small squares in the city. And we were invited, as some other architects, to work on this place. Every architect has a different place. So this was a little square, a part of the city center, in a kind of a quiet neighborhood, which is not really a place where you need to pass by. And when we went there for the first time, we were surprised by the feeling of beauty that we had from this space. So immediately, the question, what means embellishment? In fact, the city was expecting what they have done as a prototype in another square. It means that to refurbish all the floors, to make a new granite pavement or a concrete pavement, to change the lamps, to design new benches. But we continued to go there, and finally, we had 4 months to provide with the project. And after the fourth month, we came back to the city, to the commission of this project, and we explained our feeling that why we found this place beautiful. We explained also that there were some little problems, like the cleaning of the ground, which was not so often as in some other historical part of the city, the trash container, which was not at the right place. But we say that at the question of embellishment of this square, our answer is, this square for us is already beautiful, and our project is to do nothing. So doing nothing is a project. It's not. It doesn't mean that you refuse to do, but it means that it's the right way of doing our practice of architecture. It's not building for building. It's looking at the situation, evaluating, observing, analyzing, comparing with the program, with a brief, and at the end, to give your opinion. Should we build this? Should we build something else? Or should we build nothing? So revive abandoned places, to reuse, to re-give life, to invent uses. That was the topic of Palais de Tokyo in 2000, this building that was built in 1937 as a double museum for the city of Paris and the state for modern art, was in fact divided in two. And at the origin, it was a national modern art museum then afterwards in 75 moved to Centre Pompidou. And this place knew different histories of the photography museum until a big project of transformation for a kind of palace of cinema. So the project, the competition was done, the project started, the construction started 1 year, and after 1 year of construction, the Ministry of Culture decided to stop the project. And the building stayed inside in this situation with a lot of things destroyed, concrete floors open because the project has planned different organization, different stairs and so on. And this situation stayed something like 3 years until the state decided to make a temporary installation inside for young creation, mean for young artists and different disciplines. So, but the intention of the state was not to renovate it. It was clearly a temporary, to find a temporary use of it and to make a little refurbishments, so the building should not continue to degrade. So the building is 26,000 square meters. The brief for this installation was to use as much as we could for a budget of 3 million of euros. In fact, the state didn't really believe that it could be possible, but they were doing that because some artists had made some project and they wanted to go in that way. So we answered the competition, and the competition was just to make not a project, but to have 4 pages of intentions. And our intention was described like this, that for us is, the place was absolutely fascinating. Was the architecture was already there, and that was a great value. And we thought that in the project of installation, probably we had just to clean it, to repair the broken columns, to repair the broken floors, to install new stairs where they have been broken, or new elevators, or new electricity. And probably we say that after that, we would have spent the 3 million, but it could be ready to open to artists of any kind. And that was enough, because in fact, we didn't feel the need of making a small surface absolutely new, absolutely pretty, with white walls. And we thought that it was more interesting to try to re-engage the building into to the way of the regeneration by repairing what was broken, and to expect that in a way this temporary could stay long, or could be followed by another temporary. Because in a way today, it could be a good strategy to think the buildings, not to think buildings for a long term, a long kind of eternity life, but for a succession of temporaries. And here we were really in this situation that it could be possible. So we proposed a series of little interventions of reparations. And finally, doing that, we arrived to open 7,000 square meters among the 26,000, but we also repaired all the structure that was ready for another series of intervention if needed. So that was an unusual project, because we could not have a global vision of things, but it was a set of micro intervention. These columns should be repaired in that way, because it was not solid anymore. This one should be treated in another way, because it was just an issue of fire security. So we did a kind of a strategy of piece by piece, case by case, with a goal to open in the maximum of volume for exhibition and to open the door to the public again. So, and this was in 2000. It reopened in 2002. And finally, after five years of installation, the state decided to continue another 5 years. And in 2010, they decided to put another budget of 12 million to continue kind of repairing. And we see that now it's a kind of process of long life, because the success of this place was so big that in a way it's a reality that the place is there, and now it would be probably difficult to change it for a new program or for a new something more new. So the all things have been let in this state, but in a way this is not a problem, because every exhibition in fact organized around a kind of intervention. For example, these walls were not part of the project. They has been made for the exhibition. And in fact, it's interesting also to deliver this kind of point zero of space that is in a way available for a lot of things. And finally, the only rule is that it should return to the point zero to give to the next the maximum possibilities of use. So at the second stage in 2010, we opened all the 26,000 square meters, including the lower levels, just by adding this new stair. And it's an incredible variety of spaces from this ground floor, which is in the dark, very convenient for videos, for films, while the upper floors, until you go to the roof, are more and more with natural light, until the last level, which is under the transparent roof. So having such a big surface is very interesting, because you are not you can use the space with their specificity. So that was a very interesting project, and also a great lesson for us. So the last level with this. So this space is also it's also interesting, because beside the project, there is also a cultural project. The place is open from midday to midnight, and it's mixing many different kind of arts. Exhibition, but also concerts, cinema, and so on. Another project of abandoned building is this industrial hall in the north in France, or France in Dunkerque. Dunkerque is a harbor on the North Sea, and this building is the only one remaining of a huge shipyard where they were building big boats that has been destroyed in the early 80s. So this building has been kept because inhabitants of the city, and most of them were workers in the shipyard, they protested against the demolition of this building, and this building was kept and let as it is until a project of Contemporary Art Center came in this place. So that was a public Contemporary Art Center, so there was a competition, and we applied to the competition. And beside the history of this place, and especially the very strange things that, in a way, the city wanted to affect a kind of memory to this building after having destroyed all the site. In fact, this building should have become, in a way, the only one, a kind of monument to the memory of the lost shipyard. But in fact, a monument is not for life. So it's why it's important to consider that first is it's what happened inside, which is the most important. So when they opened the door of this space, we discovered this amazing space of 35 meters high, 75 meters long, absolutely empty. That was the industrial hall where they did the last assemblage of the big piece of the boat before they went to the sea. So we understand better how it was so important in the memory of the workers. And in fact, this space was fascinating. And in fact, immediately we had a kind of intuition that it was a mistake to fill this void with the floors. The brief was to build inside 7,000 square meters of new floors with half storage and half exhibition space. That means that the void would have been lost. Probably the need for controlling the climate inside would have led also to change absolutely the envelope. So that was an intuition, and we kept it in mind. We tried to do the exercise of filling the void, but finally we came back to our intuition, and we decided not to fill the void, not to build the Contemporary Art Center inside, but to make a twin just beside as a new construction, exactly of same dimension, same form, but built in a very contemporary way that would welcome the program of exhibition storage in order to keep the industrial hall absolutely empty in addition to the other. So that was a kind of additional volume. So in a way, it was very close that we were not accepted to the competition, because some members of the commission say that we were out of the rule, but finally no rule imposed to stay inside. And finally, we were reintegrated in the jury for the appreciation. And finally, we won the competition, and we could build the project. And this is the result with this new hall. This one has been kept as it is, but just inside, a very few renovations to allow a lot of public to come inside. Sorry, to come inside. So this is kept as a big volume. Just to give a comparison, most of you probably know the Tate Modern Gallery in London. This volume has the same section, it's just half long. So if you imagine the Tate Modern, the capacity of this space, it's very interesting to keep it as a void and not to fill this void. So besides, this is a new construction with the stairs, which are also what is very interesting. In fact, this place, there is the sea, the North Sea, the harbor, but you don't see all of this when you are on the ground, because there is a kind of, not a wall, but something to protect from the waves. And also this new building allowed also to have also upper floors where you could discover the landscape. So the building, the stairs are out of the block of reserves of the storage and the exhibition, just to when you move from the different floors, you are in the landscape and not anymore in the exhibition. So the exhibition rooms that respond to the program. The connection between the two buildings with a gap of 4 meters that in the master plan was supposed to be a pedestrian and bike way, and we kept it, so today it's still possible to cross the building as a pedestrian. And you see here the connection between the existing building and the new one. And some platforms from the new part allows to see from the top and to appreciate also the feeling of the height. And also we repaired all the rolling cranes, so it's also a value for some big artworks to have also all these installations. So again, the connection. So of course, this project, the economy is very important, because we proposed to do this double, but it was clear that it should be made within the budget given for the construction. But in fact, the new building is probably more simple to do as a new building as if we had to do the same inside an existing. So the economy is also something very interesting, because it's always important to go behind what is generally said. This is more expensive than this. And it's said forever. But if you go behind, if you try to understand the mechanism between construction, architecture, and economy, you become more free in the way you are dealing with the projects and the final results. So the second part of this topic of transformation is one which is very important for us, and you mentioned this in the introduction, is about this what to do with this big amount of the housing stock that has been built in the cities in the 60s, 70s, which today is in a way at the end of a first life, but not at the end of the life. And in many places, the situation is critical, because these places has become like peripheries, places where, in a way, the equipment has not been made in enough quantity. The transport are not going there. In a way, it's a little rejected part of the cities, because they don't have the same facilities as the city centers or the first circle of the suburbs. But at the same time, it's a huge amount of housing where many, many people are living today, very often with low rents. And this is very important to think what to do with that, because in fact we cannot imagine in the cities that in one end you build new housing with the most excellent requirements of construction, of energy saving, and in the other hand the majority of housing which is existing has not access to these qualities. So that was for us a very important topic: transform the housing blocks to upgrade quality, to extend the living space, to increase the pleasure and comfort, because housing is never an issue of quantity. It's always an issue of life, of pleasure and comfort. We have, as an architect, we have never to forget this. To do more with less, with and for inhabitants. So in France, as I mentioned before, in the early 2000s, the government decided an important program of demolition of these neighborhoods based on something like 200,000 demolition that should be replaced by the same amount of new building. For a huge amount of money, the cost for one demolition and rebuild was around 180,000 square meters per apartment. On the other hand, the money given for renovation was 15,000 euros, which just allows to renovate electricity, plumbing, entrance, windows, something like that. But it cannot allow to ask the question how we can bring these buildings into a new cycle of life, which will be valuable until 30, 40 years. So this picture is the one we saw many times in France in the last 20 years. Until now, the government has almost demolished 200,000 housing, rebuilt 120,000, so it means there is a loss of 80,000, and the budget spent for this is more than 20 billion. So in the early 20s, when 2000, when we saw this situation together with a friend, Frédéric Druot, we studied together in Bordeaux, and we were also together on the first feeling of this demolition. We decided to study carefully the issue, because we could, as an architect, we couldn't accept to think that a building of less than 50 years, built in a quite good condition, of course, again, with mistakes, with problems, modern architecture could be decided so bad that the only solution would be to destroy it. So for us, it was an important, we were really committed in this subject. So we decided to study a number of cases that was included in the national program. And just to give numbers, as I explained before, the national program, it's 165,000 per dwelling. Today is much more, 180 or 200,000 per dwelling demolished and rebuilt. And on the right hand, it was a result of our study of transformation of these existing blocks that allowed to renovate, to extend life, to give more living space. And in all the case studies that we did, we arrived around 55,000 euros for a very ambitious renovation, including all technical details like heating, electricity, etc. So, of course, it was extremely difficult to talk about this because the national program, which involved many different ministries, culture, housing, economy, and so on, they were, of course, absolutely sure that this program was the right one. But we approached this study with radicality, because facing the radicality of the demolition, for us, we didn't see any other way that a radical opposition. Of course, it's not really an opposition. You can imagine a three-person and the government. But in a way, for us, we found it important to do it. And we say this sentence as a kind of statement: never demolish, never subtract, never remove or replace, always add, transform, and utilize with and for the inhabitants. So it means that with and for inhabitants, it's very important. Because when you visit these places, it's not just blocks built somewhere in the suburb. It's also a huge amount of families living there for many years. And you can imagine when somebody comes and say your building will be demolished because it's nothing. And the people themselves, they think that they are nothing. So it's why it's important to consider that a housing block is not a construction. It's a place where many people are living. So it's why to consider the problem not from outside, but from inside, from the point of view of the living space. And we did finally we published this research that we named PLUS in 2004. We published it in Spain because in France we couldn't talk about that to anybody in the administration. But we found this publisher. And in fact, this transformation was a long study. We studied also beside these buildings of the suburbs, also the equivalent built in rich neighborhoods, built in the same way with the same kind of construction, but made with more care for the quality. And today, these buildings, and I'm sure that you have a number here in Milan. All these buildings today, they have a value. Nobody thinks to demolish them. So we try to think what happened so that starting from the same intention, from the same construction, why some of them fails and why the other today are remarkable housing and remarkable architecture. And in fact, we can see that in a way at the time, in the 60s, 70s, everything was built very fast. There was a kind of fascination of the urban planners and the architects to work on this kind of master plan, looking from the top and playing with sugars to place the kind of master plan. But you know that one sugar is something like 500 families. So it's why it's important to consider the thing from inside. And in fact, it was built fast. It will be, and in fact, I don't judge people of this time, because probably they did what they could. And we have not to be arrogant with our predecessors. But we have to analyze the situation and to see what could have been made in different way so that we can learn from the situation. And in fact, building so fast, building it at so big scale, in fact, in a way, forgot to think to the quality of the housing itself, of the quality of space. So while there are interesting situations like this, there are very small windows. You cannot profit on landscape, nothing to go outside. But if you just open the facade and make a balcony, then you look like the very good housing made at the same time in the same city, but in more prestigious neighborhoods. So it's just what we propose to do in the transformation of housing. And of course, we studied carefully the economy to see how we could do that with the same budget of demolition and reconstruction, or even more, like the 55,000 euros. So, and that was for us clear that, sorry, it's in French, that finally every dwelling, as you can see, there is a big reference to the case study house. And this picture, probably you recognize the case study in California with the Schulman picture. But it's a kind of simple, iconic vision of what the housing space could be. And we say for us, every dwelling should have the same facilities as a villa. So the transformation of existing housing is clearly the opportunity to upgrade massively the quality of all housing and to provide with very good housing for all, with less money, in a more sustainable way, with less CO2 footprint, and in a more sustainable way. So just two examples. One is a very old project that we did something around 2005 in a small city, the same one as the first project in the forest. In fact, the competition was about this small neighborhood, little blocks of housing. This place was, in fact, this place is a place where they built big boats. And at the time also when they built that, there was also regular connections between the city and Casablanca by boat. And this neighborhood was called Little Morocco, because most of the drivers of the boats, finally they were living there, and they were bringing back many things from Morocco, then this neighborhood became that. So the brief of the competition was to demolish all this part and to replace, there is something like 36 dwellings, and it was to replace it by new housing of 55 dwellings. So looking closer, this was this neighborhood. And again, the contradiction in the brief was that on one hand, we were asked to demolish and rebuild something. On the other hand, the owner gave us a huge amount of pictures like this just to celebrate the charm of the place, the quality of the surroundings, and to say, The new housing should have this charm. But how can you imagine that this charm, made over 50 years, could be made immediately when you make a new construction? So sometimes it seems that people are blind, that they don't see where is the value, where is the quality. I think that everybody would like to live in such a neighborhood with such tree, with, and the people, they didn't complain. They were very happy to live there. So that was a strong case, because the brief was very clear, and they say that it was a condition of exclusion not to follow the brief. But for us, in a way, finally we discovered something very important, that where is the risk in the competition? Is it to win a competition that you don't like, or is it to lose a competition but you have liked to make the project? And finally, we choose our side. And we decided to say, no, we can do better. We can provide with 55 dwellings, but keep the existing. So we propose to keep the existing, but to extend with some extra construction in front, and also on part of the plot, which was unused by a car parking. We propose to make this new building to complete up to 55 dwellings. And all this could be made without removing the inhabitants. Because in a way, as you know, when you remove inhabitants from a place, they never come back. Because the process of construction of a new project is so long that after a few years, 3 years, 4 years, the people who have, the families who have made their new life somewhere else, finally they decided to stay. They keep with them their regrets all their life, but they prefer to stay. So it's very important also to consider that, in a way, as architect, we can have also this skill to design construction that allow to work without removing the activity or removing the inhabitants. So that was the master plan. So from the existing situation, that was very nice to stay. Just this extension in front, so that would the opportunity to make additional living room, to create new lifts, because there were no lifts on this place, to make the disabled access, but without changing the interior space. So that project in 2005 was already a kind of preliminary study of what we have done much later. We didn't win the project, but it opens to us, in a way, a field of discussion, of example that we could afterwards discuss with some other clients. And finally, to conclude with this transformation of housing block, this is the most recent project that we did, that we finished almost in 2020, something like that. And this is about these three housing blocks built in the very late 60s, part of a very big neighborhood in the city of Bordeaux, which is very prominent because Bordeaux is a very low stone city, and this place is visible from everywhere. At the time, it was a new neighborhood of 4,000 dwellings, a little bit rejected by the citizen because it was so new, so different. But finally, as it is very close to the city center, today it's much more integrated. And even the UNESCO integrated this neighborhood into the perimeter of protection, which is something very great because it's also a proof of the recognition of the value of this time of construction. So we had to work on this. The city has a plan to demolish these three blocks, 530 dwellings. The only problem is that to demolish and to relocate, it takes 10 years because you have to rebuild 530 new dwellings, and you cannot just take the stock of construction of every year. So that was probably the chance of this place that finally the owner, a social housing company of the city of Bordeaux, that convinced the mayor that another way was possible with no demolition but transformation. So as you see here, it is a very huge blocks, but is it a problem that it is a huge block? What is important is to go inside. And this is very important not to stay there, because those who decide to demolish is because they stay far away. And they declare that it's ugly, that nothing is possible, that renovating is more expensive than demolishing and rebuilding. So they have this kind of pre-made sentence that finally makes a decision. What is important is to go inside, to visit every apartment, one after one, to meet the people, and to consider that these blocks, they are place for live, for life. That the blocks in themselves, the structure are still very good. There is no problem of structure. So there is just a kind of obsolescence of buildings of 50 years that could be transformed and renovated. So when you visit all these places, you are absolutely fascinated by the variety of the ways of life, of the decorations. You cannot imagine the number of collections that the people are able to do. It's like little museums. but collection of everything, puppets, I don't know, posters of big of Nadal, little I don't know, keys, everything. So, and this place is really touching to see how every people is taking so much care to their interior space. So, and when you leave the space, you don't see anymore the block. You don't care that it's a big block. You just have in mind that finally you will make a project for 530 people. And everything starts from there, from inside out. And this is very important to keep this in mind. Oh, it's blocked. It's blocked. Oh, yeah. Just a few pictures to show the variety of the interiors. And as an architect, we immediately think that we had to improve the building, we have to transform, but we have not to touch this, because it's so precious that we have really to develop invention, to develop how to make the construction, how to deal with technical problems, so that we can keep all of this, but at the same time, improve, upgrade the quality of the building and the technique. So we proposed to, it was a competition, and we won the competition, and finally we proposed to make the transformation, to give more space without removing any inhabitant. The interior space were in a good state. It was well maintained by the owner, so there were not so many problems inside, just electricity to renovate, plumbing, sanitaries, bathroom, and so on. But what we proposed, because in a way, the addition, giving more space, allows to solve in a very good way a lot of technical problems. If you add, if you make an extension like this with a winter garden, you solve the problem of insulation, because the winter garden is a buffer zone.